All right, well, this should be our final video for the 1 to 1,000 scale Discovery Enterprise. We're going to start off with this one, finishing the nacelle. Last video, we did all the pattern work and the gray on the front here. Now we're going to finish off all the detail work. So on that, you're going to need this sheet here that has the nacelle forward details and also sheet 14. Our first one we're going to be doing are these ones with the cutouts in them. We're going to be placing these over top of the gray we had painted on there before, the storm gray, and then we're going to be painting a mixture of one part black and one part of the storm gray. So I've already got these cleared, and we can cut them out and get them on. These ones you have to put the clear on them. You can't just put these on without them, because there's, with all the little details and that, the mask will distort as you pull it off. So first one here is an outboard, so that's this guy right here. So we'll just place this right over top. Now if you're worried about pulling paint off with masks, some people have been voicing concerns about that, just put it on your hand, pull some of the tack off, and then you should be fine with that. Or like I said, I use a hairdryer to help soften it up as I'm removing it, and seems to be okay. So this one, you're just going to start at the back like we've did all the other ones and move it forward. And then just give it a push down. Don't give it a rub. I mean, there's some really thin parts here. You just want to push that down and get that. Okay, so the next one we've got here is inboard. So now we just go to the inboard one, so the one straight across from that one. It's this guy right here. These ones, like I said, you don't have to cut close. You're just using the clear to transfer it from the sheet to the model. So okay, so we got the outboard and the inboard one done. The top and bottom we don't have to do right now. That's a different color pattern. So we can shoot those with the one part storm and one part black, and we'll come right back. Okay, we're back. You can see that there's the little gray box. It's just, like I said, one part of the storm gray, one part of the black. It's just enough just to make a little bit of a difference. You don't want it to be too much of a contrast, just a subtle little difference on there. Okay, so we've got this one done, and then we got this one done. Now we're going to get on to the detail for these two, and they're just these ones right here. Everything's on sheet 14, and we're going to be pulling these two off, and these ones will be painted with one part of the storm gray and one part of the pale gray. So let's get these off. All right, we can give those a shot right now. These are, like I said, one part of the storm gray, one part of the pale gray, and we'll be right back. Okay, well, we got the other gray painted on, and we've got it pulled off, and hopefully you can make that out. It's just a subtle little detail that goes on the front just to make those, the front of the nacelles, a little interesting. We got that one going on this side. All right, let's move on. Let's move on to this one here. So this one is sitting at the top, right in here. So this pattern right here, that's this guy right here, and there's also the same pattern will be at the bottom. All right, those two patterns are on. This is going to get a coat of two parts of the stormy, one part of the pale gray, and we'll be right back. Okay, one thing I just want to show you is, even though these are pretty fine little details here, the masking tape that I need to put around there for painting is very minimal. It's a couple straight lines and you're pretty much done. So just wanted to show you guys that. again, very subtle, but it's just something that adds a little interest to that front. Well, there's our four nacelle fronts. We have one more thing to do on the nacelle, and we can call the nacelle done, and that's on sheet 19, your registry logo. It's designed to place right in between these two little ridges here, or right in between the two pennants. There's a center line there, so you just center it in there, same way we did the underside and the top side. Get that on, mask it off, give it a couple, you know, maybe four light coats of flat black, and that should do that for you. We're working on a pattern for this, so you can actually paint your pennants on. The problem with it is it's so fine that if you don't get it right on, it's going to look funny. I'm almost thinking the decals would probably work the best. Maybe put like a little bit of gloss, just paint with a brush a little bit of gloss here so the decals don't have any silvering on them. Or maybe just cut really close to those. Place the decals on, and then once they're dry, maybe just take a brush and some matte or a flat clear and just paint over it, and then that will match your registry. All right, well, let's get that put on and see how that comes out. All right, the clear is on. The only thing you're gonna have to do is cut the clear as close to the registry on this side, because it's actually going to sit in between. And like I said, just put it in here and use those little center ticks just to kind of center it in that, whatever that raised area is. And then center the front. Push it down the center. Finish off the sides. We'll pull the clear off and we'll get this shot black and we'll be right back. Okay, well, we gave this about four coats of light or black, so four light coats. So we can just pull this off and see how this worked. There you go. This nacelle is completed. We'll one down, one to go. Well, for our next thing, we're going to finish the bridge detail. We've got all this mask all done here. So sheet 19, you have your first pattern. So we just want to cut these out as close to the mask as we can, because they do follow a curve. And for these ones, you want to, again, if you want to take the tack off, go ahead. This will just help not lift any paint. All right, with these ones, we're going to start at the back, up at this top, and then follow that natural grid line all the way to the bottom. And then around the top. Now again, like everything else, there's a lot of compound curves on here, so it's going to take a while to get this mask to sit down properly. But again, like I said before, it's just a pattern, so all we got to do is just get it down to where we can and then find a corner and start pulling the clear off and tapping down as you get there. As you pull some off, tap it down. Okay, I'll get the other side on. This is our first pattern, so it's going to be the pale gray. So what I'll do is I'll get that other pattern on, I'll give it a shot of paint, and I'll come back and we'll get it set up for the second pattern. Okay, so we got a light coat of our pale gray on. We're just going to take the tape off here. And see, by just taking a little bit of that tacked off the mask with your hands, it comes off really nice and clean. All right, there's our first coat, or our first pattern. Our second pattern is on sheet 14. We're going to do the same thing, put that pattern on. We're going to give that one coat of our second pattern color, which I believe is the two parts of Storm and one part of the Pale. And we'll be right back. All right, well, our last coat has been put on, our two part Storm Gray and our one part Pale. Pale gray, that's for our second Aztec mask color. There's our bridge detail done. Okay, so I guess our top saucer is done. The only thing I'm gonna do is repeat this pattern over on this side, get rid of this one. This is kind of what you're gonna see. All right, that one's done. All right, we're gonna work on the engineering hull. We're gonna work on the front deflector area in here. We have a two-part mass system that we'll be going on off of sheet 20. These ones I would put on as a whole mask and then weed them off after. They're really small and you have chances of pulling them off and not getting them properly positioned again. So with these ones, we're just going to cut along each one of the straight lines as close as we can, and on the long curve side as close as we can. This side you can go as close as you can. This side doesn't matter because this side is on the outside anyway. So all you have to do is you have to just watch where this pattern is. So we have this pattern here starting on this one. So this one is going to be on the bottom. So what we'll do is we'll pull this guy off. This guy starts on this side. We just as tight in the corner as you can get it. Just like we did the blackout masks. And just follow it around. Try and get it to seat as best you can, and then you can remove the clear. Just find one corner and slowly work it back. And just like we did the bridge, you just kind of just tap this. Okay. Maybe just like we worked on the cell, just get the Q-tip and you can rub in all the corners. Now we might as well just do this one because these ones are going to alternate around just so we can see which way we're going. We're going to be moving the two squares that are in there, so let's just go ahead and do that now. All right, we'll just reverse that all the way around here, and then we're going to be spraying that with the one part of aluminum and one part of the flat black, same color we used on the base, and then we'll move on. So I'll finish the rest of these masks, and we'll come right back. All right, well, we've got these four pieces on around the first part of the forward deflector. I'm just going to go over a few points that I found as we were putting these on. One is, once you put your clear on, make sure you use your tweezers and get in these corners, because these little pieces here are really, really small. And once you get it all pressed down and you start pulling your clear off, it's best to pull the clear off from this side into the center. Then you'll keep this little piece in place, and then go to this side and pull the clear off to the center, and then you can pull the whole thing off. And that'll keep everything in place. The other thing I've noticed is sometimes right on the edge here and on this edge, these pieces are not cut 100%. So when you're lifting it off, as you're lifting it off from this side, you might pull this piece off right in here. So what I would suggest is start pulling from this side, and you might even need a razor blade just to, it's like the gum or the stick that's on the bottom of these masks hasn't been cut all the way through. In order for us to get this kind of level of detail, there's a fine line of where you can go, where you can cut too deep or not deep enough. If you don't cut it deep enough, you might have to have a little razor blade just to get that line started. If you cut too deep, what the cutter does is it actually pulls this piece right off the page and then you don't even have it. So that's one of the things there. This is probably, being the size, this and the front deflector will probably be the hardest part of this model to deal with the masking. But when, if you take your time and work at it carefully, everything will work out fine. We're going to mask this off. We're going to paint it with our silver black base coat, and we'll come back and we'll continue on with the second step. All right, we got our aluminum and our black painted on the step one mask for the deflector. Take all this stuff off for now. And we remove all of the mask that we had on there. And you don't need a very very thick coat of the silver. As you can see, the silver, just a light dusting of silver makes it show up nicely. All right. Okay, well, there's our first coat, or our first pattern for the front deflector. Our second pattern is going to be, again, off of sheet 20. We're going to place this piece right over top of those, and then we're going to remove the pattern that, as shown here. Again, just like before, cut as close as you can on the short sides and on this long side. Now again, these patterns, you're going to have to watch. You can see how there's this three pattern here which sits over top of this square. So you got to make sure you don't get these reversed. And my three pattern is on this top side. So it'll be this guy right here. And then, like I said, if you leave the clear a little long on this short side, it gives you something to grab onto and start to pull it off. I'm tapping it down as you go along. Just use your tweezers to get the corners in. And then just using your razor blade at a sharp angle. Lift a corner. So we'll continue on getting the rest of those masks on, and then this is now going to get a coat of two part of the stormy gray and one part of the pale gray. All right, well, I've got the mask on this for the second pattern. One thing I've noticed, and I changed the way I was doing it, is this one you can weed. This one's pretty easy to pull off. If it's weeded, then it's a lot easier to see where it's gonna go. As I said, you can weed it on the model, but this one, being that there's a border around it, it's pretty easy to lay in, and it's also a lot easier to see what position it needs to go in. So we're going to mask that off, and we're going to shoot it with two parts of the stormy gray and one part of the pale, and we'll be right back. All right, well, we got our final coat of paint on our front deflector for the first part of it. That's this part in here. Let's take the tape off. All right, well, we've got our front deflector all finished on the secondary hull with our three colors. That's the pattern we've come up with. Now we just have to move on to the main front deflector. And this one has a three color pattern going on here. We'll get the masks ready for this. Pretty much the same way as this one is. The pattern just a little different. And let's get the masks cut, and we'll get to putting them on here. All right, we're getting ready to mask the front deflector. The first thing we have to do is we have to find out which one is the bottom, and then just put a black line on the bottom. That's going to be your start point for each one of these masks. As these masks overlap each other, we need to have a start point, and the bottom is kind of the most inconspicuous place to start. So let's cut our first mask, which will be this one right here. Okay, so we want to find our bottom. We're starting with this side. which will be right here. So just line it up with the center. And what we're going to do is we're going to follow this edge around, lightly tapping it. Now, just like the other masks on these compound curves, this takes a while to seat this down, but just work your way around, just align that one edge. And then we just find a corner. And just like before, as you pull some of it off, tap it down just to seat it. All right. So what we're going to do with the first one is we're going to be painting it the same as our base coat color. So it's the one part aluminum and one part of black. And we'll give that a shot and we'll come back and move on to stage two. All right, well, we got our silver, our first color on there. You can see where the silver and the gray is. Now we're going to move on to step number two, which is going to be this pattern here. And we're going to pretty much lay it up the same way we did the first one. Start the same place, go around the same way. Okay, so we're going to start on the bottom corner. Find our bottom of the deflector. Okay, now we're step two. So part one of stormy gray, one part of the pale gray. Give that a shot, and we'll come right back. All right, well, we sprayed our step number two, and you can just see here how that stormy gray and the pale just kind of sits inside that little silver box as an accent. So we've got that done. Now our third and final step is this pattern right here. Again, starting where the arrow is, starting at the bottom. Just like before, just follow it around. All right, our final paint is one part of the storm gray, one part of the black primer. And that's just for these little squares here. And then we'll see how it came out. Okay, well, we've got our final step number three completed. And we're just gonna pull the masks off. I don't know how well that turns out on camera, but you can see it's just a little shade difference. And let's grab this ship and our top one. That's kind of the front deflector pattern we came up with. Just have to finish this and the front deflector, but that's not part of the masking thing. The only other thing there is for masking, we've also included a mask for the back for the marking lights on the landing bay. You can either paint those on or use the mask to keep the clear protected while you paint the black or silver, whatever you're going to paint on there, so at least that'll glow up. There's a mask also for the bridge windows above, or the bridge dome. And I think that pretty much does it for this kit. I think we're pretty much done, all the masking that's included with the kit. And I hope you guys enjoyed the videos. We'll see you guys on the Facebook page. Post some of the pictures of your bills and any issues you're having or anything you find that's different that might help everybody else. And thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.